All right, looks like we are on the air. Let's see.
Oh, yeah, okay, this does appear to be working. So I've got a...
We're live.
Let's get questions.
It says, no podcast this week. We're holding a live Google Plus Hangout right here, right now. Link, does that work?
Here we go.
We have somebody in already. They've already asked a question.
Hey, Ruben Flint.
All right, let's get going. Let me get my Twitters open here so I can see what that's all about. I don't know, this Twitter thing may catch on.
Yeah, maybe.
I think I agree with you, Larry. It might become quite popular.
It may. I don't know.
I think you would be happy joining such a thing.
Yeah, I think it should make sense. All right, well, we're getting started now. Hi, guys. I'm Larry here, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. I'm wearing my reading glasses because I'm reading the screen. Welcome, and thank you for coming tonight. E, I saw you making faces over there.
Yep. I was going to say something about your reading glasses, but then didn't.
Okay, well, that's fine if you need to do that. And then, of course, over there, right in the middle in the pink is Laura. Say hello, Laura.
Hello.
Hello, Laura.
Good to be here.
Wait, you're not in the middle anymore. You moved.
Well, it's funny. We talked about this. Whenever someone speaks, then their main focus happens, and then they go full screen. And I think it bounces around in the below there. So there you go. Hey, there's a link here. Apparently, it's on YouTube as well. Jeff, I'll put that in the chat so we can all tweet that out. Go, here it is. So I just tweeted that out. Hopefully you guys are seeing that.
I just pushed a...
hopefully it's in the same one. But anyway, welcome, guys. We're gonna hang out with you guys for an hour. Apparently, when we started up the broadcast, Google Plus said we could do it for 8 hours, and we said no.
We said no. An hour.
So I'm gonna open up my computer here and look at some tweets while we're kind of going through here. So I figure we'll just get through, talk about what we're doing and how you guys are doing and all that other stuff. So, Laura, what are you playing? You haven't played anything this week.
What do you mean I haven't played anything this week? We haven't played anything together, but I have been playing stuff on my own because when I'm online, you're not. So this is focused on E right now. Can you guys hear me?
No, it's focused on you.
You don't see it when you're talking. You have to look at E, and then it's distracting, and then you lose your train of thought. And
exactly.
Thanks, Google.
Yep.
All right, so games that I've been playing. I've been playing Destiny, even though I don't think I saw any of you guys on when I was playing. I finally made it to Venus.
Yes.
And yay. I must say, have you guys taken a look around the landscape of Venus?
Oh, I was having this conversation. I think it was Jeff and I. I am hard-pressed to find somebody who does skyboxes better than Bungie.
I completely agree. Their skybox artist is phenomenal.
So the skybox, for those of you that don't know, is the bottom of the sky. It's all the sky stuff.
It's the box that's in the sky.
Yeah, I feel like that wasn't a term that I had ever heard until Destiny came out and everyone started talking about skyboxes.
Oh, really?
That's a sign.
No, I've heard that one a lot.
Well, it's
common
if you
have.
Well, I don't develop
every
games.
Game has. Sorry. Well, now you know.
Hey,
but I'm mostly impressed with the fact that they're animated, number one. But in Venus, there is a massive volcano that spews out bright blue lava, and I was just so blown away that I had to stop and run towards it and take a look at it because it was just so gorgeous.
Wait a minute. We're doing this hangout, Laura.
Mm-hmm.
Did you bring props?
No.
What is that behind you?
Why?
She's in her office.
Okay, I just noticed she's got Laura. For those of you who don't know, Laura's gamertag, of course, is Lollipop. And then behind her is...
You're talking about my Lollipop?
That's exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah, so this is something that I made for a costume, actually, a couple of years ago for Halloween. I dressed up as a castle crusher.
Right.
And one of the swords that you can purchase, one of the DLC packs, gives you a lollipop sword. So there's actually a sword that's a lollipop for Castle Crashers. So I made it to carry around as, you know, the Castle Crashers sword. I think that's on Facebook somewhere.
Yeah, I remember that, actually.
Yeah, it was really
so
fun.
What came first, Laura as lollipop or the lollipop sword on Castle Crashers?
You know what always amazes me? And I love, we all love Castle Crashers. Mm-hmm. But you know what I love is I love that every year... they bring the game to PAX, and there's always a line. The game's been out for, like, 5 years.
Yes.
Right? To their credit, they have, like, the big, like, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles four-player across arcade cabinet.
Right.
Custom-made. And that's a fun way to play that game.
That's the exciting thing about it, I think.
Yeah.
So apparently, so really, I'm not sure. If you guys have any questions, go ahead and hit the Q&A. We're not quite sure how it works and how you guys see it on your side, but on our side, we see a Q&A panel, and we can see some questions coming. So we'll get to those. So if you have any questions, occasionally we will go through them. We can't talk about stuff that hasn't been announced, so let's all respect that, but we're happy to answer any other questions.
Someone asked if you lift, Larry. Has that been announced yet? Your swoleness? What's the ship date on that?
Really? Really, Laura? Really?
Sorry. Found that funny. Yes,
you've done all the other memes. They're in yes.
They're in
X app.
Anyway, go ahead, Laura. I'm sorry, you're talking about what you're playing.
Oh, okay. Other games that I've been playing is Defense Grid 2.
Yes. Thank you.
He has not had a chance to talk about Defense Grid 2, so we talked about it last week when you were off the show. I think I was the only one who had played it. No, Jeff had definitely played it, but I was mostly talking about it because Jeff and I were competing with some scores in a couple of levels that we played together.
That did not last long for me.
No, but E is pretty much on a crazy trend of massive scores, so it's going to take a while to catch up to E from where he is. I think you are not number one on my leaderboard, but you are number two, a close second to Sarah, you probably know.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. I have not started replaying levels for score yet. Mm-hmm. I've just been, as I get time going through, I'm having a ton of fun, though. Nice. But I think I'm going to wait until I finish the story before I start replaying levels for score.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a really, really fun game. Having a ton of fun of that so far. And still, like E, working my way through the story. I think I'm only down 4 or 5 levels or something, so I'm not that far in. But
yeah, I went into his office the other day, and he was playing it. He claims it was waiting for a meeting to start. I don't know if that's true.
I didn't say how long it was until the meeting.
You did not. That is true. You did not.
It could have been 3 hours to the meeting, man. I wish.
By the way, if you're wherever you're tuning in from, let us know. Is there a chat room here? I mean, I know we got the Q&A. Is there a way we can see what people are posting or not? If not, well, regardless. So as you can see, we're all sitting in our respective E's at his house. Say hello, E, at your house.
Hello.
You're not only in his house, you're in his kitchen. Why don't you share your pantry with us?
See? Food.
That's a lot of food. A lot of processed food. Are you okay?
Yeah.
I'm good.
And Jeff is at his home in Seattle in his game room.
Yes, this is where the people stay and displace me from my game room when they come to visit.
And then Laura doesn't have a home because her office is the home, so she's at the office.
I am at the office right now.
What none of us know is Laura hasn't had a home in years. She just lives at work.
Right, under her desk.
Totally mm-hmm. possible, and none of you can come visit me because I'm behind all sorts of secure doors, so you can't even confirm if I'm there or not.
That's going to make a great movie, though. Like, it'll be like a Pursuit of Happiness or something where you've been sleeping.
To think of it, I'm not even convinced you work there. You may not even work in my building.
That's true. You haven't seen my office in quite some time.
Yeah. And then I'm at home. I'm at my house. This is my man cave. And then that's my backyard. I've got the window open because it's beautiful here in Seattle.
I hear that.
Dank man cave. It's well done. It's like a man solarium. lots of light.
Well, I've got these are my Hue lights here. Check this out. So this is, I'm going to show you this. So I've got Hue lights all around my
Show us.
So you want to? So this is I've got a bunch of presets, and as I'm playing games, because my TV is right here, I can actually set it up to be green. So those are green because I kind of turn it down. Or if I want to turn it red, I can turn it red.
So how are you controlling it? Show us.
I've got a iPad right here.
Can you set it for different shades of colors, like here's a Pantone setting?
You can actually put it here. This is sunset. Ooh, that's
so
scary.
If I give you Pantone colors, can you set it to that, like RGB?
Yes, you can do RGB. I've not done that. You can actually use an ink dropper on the app and say, okay, take that color. So this is just...
So can I give you a color right now and have you set it?
Sure, you want to do that?
Okay, do you want it in RGB or hex?
Let me take a look here. Okay,
is this going to be thunder yellow? Because at the University of Oregon, thunder has a color.
Edit.
Not thunder yellow. It's lightning yellow.
Damn it. And thunder green. Thunder green.
There you go. You'll get it.
Ethereal purple.
You know, actually, I haven't done that before, E, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it here. I mean, I'm sure I can. I don't want to waste everyone's time while I'm trying to figure out how to use my light.
I was just curious.
So, yeah, so this is called Grease. I don't know why. This is called Hammock, because it's like lying in a hammock. It all looks the same, I know. I don't really get it either. This is Blue Rain. I kind of like that. That's a little dramatic. Anyway, so, yeah, so this is welcome to my, what did you call it, Jeff?
Man Solaria.
It's
although I kind of like Man Veranda or like Man Random. We'll workshop it.
Okay. Anyway, so this is it's a little abnormal in here because let me turn that back on.
It's nice.
There you go. Thank you. And my dog is behind me, but I'm not gonna. She's sleeping. All right. So anyway, we're talking about what we're playing. Laura, you talked about Destiny. What else are you playing?
And Defense Grid 2. We talked about that.
DG 2. Yep.
And the last game I've been playing, of course, is Diablo 3. So. I won't go on and on about it. I'll probably pass the baton to somebody else because you've heard me talk about Diablo 3 for weeks and weeks and weeks, but I'm still playing it.
Before we go on to E, we're going to go to you next about what you're playing. I'm just going to take a look at some of the questions in here. Any info about the November dashboard preview?
I was actually going to say something about the questions in general.
Yes.
Everyone is plus one-ing the questions that they know we can't answer because they're asking for things we haven't announced yet. Which just drowns out the questions we can actually answer, so you might not want to do that. But it's up
anyway,
to you.
So any information about the November dashboard preview? The answer is not yet. Anyway, that's all. So let me just go ahead and click that. Mark that as done for now. All right, E, what are you playing?
Defense Grid 2. Fair amount of that. I played some last night to... distract myself from my sorrows. It is a really good game. If you like tower defense, pick it up. It's a blast. Oh, hi, Cthulhu. I have a puppy. So I've probably been playing that more than anything. I think I'm about done with Destiny. We finished the story. I hit level 20. I got some light
gear. When did you finish the story?
You were there. In the game. It was you, me, and Jeff.
All right.
That's right.
Oh, that's right, because you weren't here last week. Never mind. Okay.
Larry, someone's asking to see your toilet. I'm just saying. Wow. Just throwing it out there.
Or, well, no. it's right over there. So.
Wow. So Defense Grid 2, Little Destiny.
Here. Hold on a second. Well, you can answer that question. I'll just go ahead and do this. Hold on.
Is he going to bring the toilet to us?
That
would be amazing.
I think so, but... Now I'm a little scared, to be honest. Hi, puppy. He's wondering who I'm talking to. He doesn't really like this whole video conferencing thing. A little Shadow of Mordor. I haven't gotten very far. Just far enough to know that I'm really going to like it.
I'm really looking forward to that. I haven't started playing it yet, but I hear really good things about it.
Oh, yeah. I started playing probably about 2 hours into it. And, yeah, same thing. Instantly hooked. And yeah. I like the mythology and everything, but you can just tell mechanically that, what did you do?
For me, it's the other way around. It's, you know, I'm not generally big on open world games, but I'm so interested in the mythology that I'm going to play for that.
What are you playing?
Shadow of Mordor.
Oh, yeah. I'm a little bit further than you are, Jeff. I think I'm about an hour in, and I was
at an event, a gaming event earlier this week, and some game journalists were talking about Shadow of Mordor, and they were talking about how they play it, and I totally like really identified with it. They were like, I treat it like a meal, but I'm using like just a ton of self-control. I eat my vegetables first, and I sort of circle around the edge, and then I move over to the mashed potatoes, and so we're talking like side missions and leveling up, and then they go in for the meat, which would be like the story missions, or maybe the dessert, I don't really know. And so that's what I've been doing, and randomly, like, the thing I like is so many of the different orcs or uruks have like completely different personalities, and one was pretty much like stalking me, and eventually caught me at a absolutely terrible time, and I kind of had to just book it and get out of there. And it was, we went back and forth for a long time before I was able to finally defeat him. So I thought that was really cool. And then another guy, I was just sort of sneaking through. I shanked him, and then there was like, oh, that was a captain. So I never knew him. I hope he didn't have a family.
Alas, poor captain.
We hardly knew ye.
We hardly knew you. All right, so we're moving through. Did I miss anything? Because I got some stuff for show and tell that I'll get to in a minute.
I didn't say I was done, but I think everyone does want to see the toilet. So if you want to show the toilet, we can come back to what I'm playing.
No, I'm not showing the toilet. I'm gonna spare you that. Instead, what I have are the remote controls for my toilet.
We're going to flush it on air.
So this is the really, you guys. Do you really want to see this? All right. This is the downstairs one, which is... Can you see this, Laura?
Oh, man.
Yes.
I feel like I'm in the Grand Hyatt Roppongi.
So this is the main... This is the one downstairs. You can see it's got boy stuff and girl stuff. And this is the key part. Watch this. Watch this. See. There's even more inside!
What?
So that's the inside.
What all does that do?
That's
There's
a little
so
too complicated
buttons.
For a toilet.
Well, if you take a look here, Laura, you can see over on the the left side. There's the energy savings, so you can decide what you want to happen there. The keys right here are pulsating and oscillating. And then this is where you direct the wand up and down, the pressure.
Oh my
God. Yeah, you know, you've got your seat temperature, your dryer.
Highly recommend the oscillating, pulsating. You got to work your way up to that.
So that's this one, and then that's the original one, and then this is the one I just recently got. Jeff, you know what that looks like.
I've got that, right?
So this one is the same thing. It has just as many functions, but on the back it's got a lot. It's got a little LCD screen where you can, I don't know if you can see it.
Oh, you turned the heat up to 4? I mean, that is not messing around, because 3 is really on my threshold.
So, but anyway, this
you
is...
You laugh now, but like... 20 years from now, everybody's going to have one of these, and we'll look back at the current day as the Dark Ages.
E, do you have any questions?
Can people see the puppy dog? I had a request for puppy dog, so I got the puppy dog. But he wants to get down. So.
Yeah, I don't blame him. Okay. Anyway, so in lieu of bringing you in to show you the toilets, I thought I'd show you the remote controls for the two different models I have.
I think from just looking at the remote controls, I am too terrified to even look at the toilet.
So this is why they changed it from this one to this one. This is a little more simple.
Does it work with this?
A Harmony?
Yeah.
We can try it.
You know you want to now.
So it's infrared. This is one of my favorite parts. Take a look at that. I don't know if you can read what it says.
Oh, yeah.
So, Laura, this actually this opens the seat.
I can't read that.
Seat open, close.
Seat open, close. Okay, that's awesome. So
you click on that, and it
does. A button to open it instead of...
Yeah, well, actually, let me be clear. This particular model, when you walk up to it, it will automatically open the lid, and then this is if you want to do man business.
All right. That is one sophisticated toilet.
So anyway, there you go.
The thing is, this is too much, but we're already down this
Yeah,
this
we're already down this rabbit hole.
Down this pipe, if you will. Our trash can, our trash can is very close to there, and every time I have to throw something out, and it pops up, and I'm like, oh, not now, honey. I'll be back.
Right.
I feel bad. It's like ready to go, and no, not now.
Anyway, so that's it for the toilets. Hello, Australia. I was just checking on Twitter. We've got some folks watching us from Australia. Hello there to Australia.
Hello.
So anyway, we're talking about what we're playing. E, are you all done? Or have you...
No.
Yes, okay.
So part of the reason why I was not on the show last weekend, I don't know if you guys mentioned where I was.
We do not... I didn't ask you to mention it, so I didn't mention anything. I figured you could tell us the entire story, and I certainly couldn't go anywhere near... you know, the detail that you're about to go into.
Well, I can do the detail later, but part of what I'm playing, while I was in D.C., I went to Firaxicon, a small 200-person con put on by Firaxis, the makers of Civ and XCOM. I got an hour of Civilization Beyond Earth.
Ooh.
Yeah, oh, it's so good. It's fantastic.
All right.
And had a great time in D.C. and saw some other stuff, and I'll get to that later. So,
that's it?
No, that's what I'm playing.
Oh, okay. I'm actually... Jeff, do you want to talk about what you're playing, or I can talk about what I'm playing?
Sure. So, lots of Forza Horizon 2. We've been playing together, and it's really, really fun. I love it by itself and just, you know, solo play and running around because it's just so scenic, and still, to this day, we'll... Because we've been fortunate enough to be able to have it for a couple weeks. It's nice to just stop and go, ah, that really looks good, especially when it's raining and you just see like the slick pavement and it really looks perfect.
There's a great in-game photo option, and I went in and I was taking photos of my Laura. I got this awesome VW bus.
Oh, you got a VW bus?
So Volkswagen. Volkswagen used to make a bus.
Bus in the same sentence. That's.
Did you have you ever seen Back to the Future? And then the Libyans come through Twin Pines Mall. Yes. The car they're driving. That.
Right. So this is the same thing. But I went in and I tweaked it and upgraded it. It is now a B class. So this thing is a rocket ship.
You have a very fast VW bus.
That's.
How does it handle? How does it handle?
It just hugs the road. It is like it's a rocket sled. This is a VW bus rocket sled.
The paint job is the best part.
Yeah. So the community, have you played it yet, Laura?
Not yet.
Okay. So the once again, in the grand tradition of Forza, it's got this awesome livery editor where you can go in and paint everything, and the community shares them out. So when you download a car, when you unlock a car, you can go in there and say, you see what the community has done with that specific car. And I don't know who the user is, but they went in and did this amazing Pac-Man paint job. So there's like Pac-Man all over it. It's black, and it's spectacular.
I'm going to have to use that one.
I'm going to have to look at that. That sounds awesome.
Pardon me?
Does it have the ghosts on it?
I believe it does.
Pac-Man being chased by the ghosts?
I believe it does. So I'll have to go put a picture. You can actually use the in-game photo feature, take images and shoot them up to ForzaMotorsport.net and then share them out on the web. There's this thing called Twitter-E where people use 140 characters to communicate and share stuff, so I could use that.
You're never going to get tired of that, are you?
I gotta go dig that show up. I really need to.
Now we're doing that with Elo. Now we're saying that because I'm like, are you on Elo?
Yeah, are you on Elo?
You are.
Didn't everyone get on Elo just to grab their name so that someone else couldn't take it?
What is Elo?
It's the latest Facebook killer.
The latest in a long line of Facebook killers.
Oh, I Elo, see.
Elo.co.
Okay.
Elo.
Yeah. No. Just slow.
So okay. I'm over there. My username is my last name, HRYB. Laura, if you need an invite, let me know and I'll send you an invite. Because right now it's invite only.
I see. Yeah, send me an invite. I want to grab my name if I can.
Right.
Right now it's sort of like a club that's got a really long line, and then you get in, and then you're like, so this is what they were waiting for?
Yeah, this is it?
Yeah. It's missing a few really needed features. Like, there's no block, there's no mute, there's, like, it's very early still.
I thought there was.
No, nope. They said it's coming.
Okay.
But
Anyway, I'm sorry, Jeff.
Yeah, so Forza, we've talked about it, I think, for a couple weeks now, but join our car club, I would say. So it's the Major Nelson Car Club. It's also, if you search, there's a couple different search parameters you can do, but it gets you a nice Xbox in brackets if you join the club, and I think it's worth it for that alone. And I know, like, a lot of people have, because I started the club 10 days ago, and last I looked, I was in 272nd place in the club ranking, yeah. And I've been playing a lot of the game, so there must be quite a few people in it. I think the limit's somewhere in the neighborhood of 1,000, which is nice. Okay. The other game, like we've been talking about, Shadow of Mordor. So the one thing I wanted to point out is just how intense each sort of action is. Knowing that when you die, you don't just restart from a checkpoint, but that the orc that took you down is going to get stronger and move up in the orc hierarchy. So if I'm fighting someone who's sort of weak, I'm not too worried about it because it might just move them up to a level 2 or something. But when you're fighting a tougher orc, I'm like heart pounding and just like I can't lose it, because then the next time this orc's going to move up, you know, to a major level or something like that, a higher level captain. And I don't know, just the fact that each encounter seems to mean something is something that I really appreciate.
All right, just tweeting out a note to the about the hangout now. I'm sorry. Go ahead. I don't continue.
I think it's up to you. Those are the two games I've been playing this week.
So I'm playing Shadow of Mordor, Destiny, Forza Horizon. I have another game that I have the disc for that I'll be playing probably tonight that I can't really talk about. But just imagine it's based on. How would you describe this, Jeff?
I think you can set your lamp to the first word, and I think you did earlier.
Yes, in fact, it's happening right now. We're in the middle of it. Yeah. We're in the middle of a sunset.
Huh.
So,
I hope you kick your weekend into some level of drive, some gear. I don't know which one.
So I'll be hanging out and looking at that tonight. So I'm going to see how that is. Anyway, so that's what I'm playing.
I can spoil that for you. It's great. So.
Thank you. So I don't need to play it now? Is that what you're telling me?
No, you should still play it, but you don't have to worry about how good it is.
If you're watching us right now, it's Friday night here on the West Coast. Don't know what day or time it is where you are, but thank you for tuning in. We've got a blog post up at majornelson.com. It kind of shows you some of the games that released over the past few days. It's been a very busy week, hasn't it, Jeff?
Yeah, it very much has. And the next couple of weeks, too, what's coming up. So this week, and I guess I could just go over to that blog post, we had Forza Horizon 2, Shadow of Mordor, Crime and Punishment Sherlock Holmes, which sort of snuck up on me, but I've been hearing some good things about. Chariot, which is free for everybody. It's made by Freebie Games, a great couch co-op game, and that is a Xbox One game with gold. So grab it anytime during the month of October, but why wait? And then a week ago today, we had a Friday release from ID at Xbox, which is called Kickbeat. And then on 360, we also had Forza Horizon 2, Crime and Punishment, Sherlock Holmes. But game I really want to try is P4A Ultimax, so Persona 4 Arena. It's the second one. Did any of you play the Persona games? You have to trust me that they're great, and then it's fan servicey, where it's all the characters that you may have loved, but in a the team that built the game actually has some good fighting game chops. So that's just this week, and then next week NBA 2K15, Project Sparks retail release, Alien Isolation, and there's some other stuff coming as well, and it's only October 3rd. So
here we are.
Time is becoming scarce.
We're just going to go to questions real quick. Hopefully you guys here at each of your screens can see the question. It is from Angel Lopez, who wants to know, what game are we looking forward to each this holiday season? So, Laura?
Oh, my goodness. So there's so many coming out. It's hard to choose. Let's see.
Do you guys see that on your screen, by the way? Just curious.
It does. Yeah. It pops up in blue on the right.
This side. And I have no idea, audience, I don't know if you can see it. If you can't, that's why I'm reading it to you. So anyway, go ahead, Laura. Sorry.
So I know one of the guys that E's probably going to choose, probably Alien Isolation. I'm looking forward to that. I haven't played many of the Alien games. I'm looking forward to a good one where I'm going to be basically as afraid as I was when watching the Alien series.
When I played it at E3, there was jumping and screaming. And
yes.
Now we talked about the fact that I played that level with Oculus, Jeff and I. With Oculus, mm-hmm. and Jeff and I both died at precisely the same time, and we were in a no-win situation.
I heard that it can be beaten. That at PAX, I was talking to somebody about this week, that they had like these really nice bomber jackets, and that if you beat it, then you could get one of them. And they only gave out three in the four days of PAX.
There you go. So, so what? So, Laura, that's what you're looking forward to?
So that's one. And then the other one that is obvious that I'm looking forward to is Dragon Age Inquisition.
Oh, yes.
Right. It comes out in November, and super, super excited about that one. Both Jeff and I are very, very pumped to finally jump back into the world and get our characters and horses and ride around in a massive world. So
there's like over a dozen kinds of mounts, so I'm excited.
Jeff, what are you looking forward to?
Well, Dragon Age for sure, but Sunset Overdrive is definitely... I'm looking at your shades. That's definitely, I think, top of my list. I love open world games. I've played just about every game Insomniac has ever made, so I'm just a huge fan of them personally and professionally. And it looks so colorful and nice, and I wish that I could take it from your house.
Okay. If you had it. All right. If I had it, if that was a game that I had. I'm going to go next, then E, you're going to bring up the rear. How's that sound?
Sure.
So I am looking forward to Sunset. And for a multitude of reasons, Halo Master Chief Collection. Obviously, it's all the Halos, but that to me is because I remember this. I'm going to tell this story. I don't tell this story too often, but when I joined the Xbox team in 2003, he was on the team because he's been there since dirt. And well, it is true. He was the first or second gamer tag on the service. That's right, you're the first gamer tag, and then Brian won the first multiplayer, right?
No, I beat him in football.
Okay, you beat him in football. Anyway, so I remember, because my office was about three or four down the hall from E, And I would stop in and talk to him all the time when we were becoming friends. And they were in the process of building out and getting the service ready for Halo 2, which, of course, the Halo 2 anniversary is a huge part of the Master Chief Collection. So I remember that, E. I remember that so vividly. And we played so much of that game. Laura, this was before you joined the team.
It is.
And obviously, Jeff, what were you doing at that point?
2003?
Yeah.
I was waiting in line to buy Halo 2.
Okay. So that's probably Master Chief Collection and getting back in there and playing some Halo 2, because we just had great hours and time in that, didn't we?
Yeah. Oh, I've probably played more Halo 2 than any game ever. The only one that might top it would be Civ. When Bungie took down the stat tracking for Halo 2, where you could go online and screen scrape all your games and put them in a database and analyze them if you were really crazy, not that I did that. I had about 7,500 games of Halo 2 multiplayer played, plus all the campaign that I'd done, plus all the local multiplayer. So, yeah, Halo 2 was a big part of my life for a long time.
Yeah, we had so much fun with there. So, what about you, Jeff?
I'm sorry, what was the question?
No, actually, I guess you're the next person. Did we do everybody?
I think everyone except me went.
All right, well, yeah, go ahead.
I think they've all been named already just about, but Sunset Overdrive, yeah, that's one that combines... It's not a fair description because it leaves out so much, but mentally I think of it as Crackdown plus Jet Set Radio.
Yeah, there's a graphic I put up earlier this week that we got from Gamescom, which kind of shows just a few of the games coming this holiday season. It is just this beautiful tapestry, if you will, of entertainment.
Yeah, but Sunset it's bright, it's colorful, it's funny, it's fun to play. So excited for that. Master Chief, my son and I already have plans. We have played Halo 1 through 4. And finish all four in co-op legendary mode. So between Christmas and New Year's, we're going to do that all over again with the Master Chief Collection. So I'm really excited for that.
What are you wearing, Laura?
This is a hat.
Borderlands.
Oh, yes.
Thank you.
The pre-sequel is coming out here shortly.
Like 2 weeks, I think.
I'm actually, and this is related to a question that I saw somewhere in the Q&A earlier, Fantasia. Fantasia is a fantastic Kinect game, and the first time I played it at E3, not this year but last year, I just walked out of the room with this big stupid smile on my face.
Are you? I don't know if I asked you this, Fanny. Are you an animation fan?
I think I like different animation than you, but yes, I like kind of.
I like my stuff G-rated. Is that what you're saying?
No, I prefer sci-fi animation.
Oh, right.
As opposed to cartoony animation, I guess. I don't know what to call it.
Speaking of that, can we just stop for a moment and talk about the news this week? I tweeted it out about there's no more Saturday morning cartoons.
I would have traded Saturday morning cartoons as a kid to have like six networks that are exclusively cartoons plus YouTube. I would make that trade in a second.
Well, plus, have you seen how many cartoons are on Netflix? I mean,
yeah,
but there was something about the fact you'd get up early and go down to your TV room, like I'd go down with my sisters, and you're in your pajamas, and you're watching Saturday morning, and you're having your you're having your cereal because your mom or your dad gave it to you. There's something special about that.
There is, but I used to do that, and I'd wake up and eat just like cereal that was horrible for you and loaded with sugar, marshmallows and cereal. That's the thing. So. And we had one channel, maybe two, that showed any cartoons, and a lot of them were trash, but I watched them because they were cartoons. And
it was all that was on.
Everything is on demand. They can watch good stuff whenever they want. So that's one that I romanticize. I have great memories, and if I could switch with my kid, I would do that in a second.
Yeah, but I'll just tell you this. I don't know about you, but I'm a big fan of the Warner Brothers cartoons. That is here's a little tip. I love doing this. Laura, you watched, of course, Bugs Bunny and all those, right?
Of course I did, yes.
Everybody did. Watch those cartoons, because they're 8 to 10 to 12 minutes long because they preceded the feature. That's what it was back in the day. But what's even more impressive is that they were all produced with about 10 people. If you look at the credits, it's 10, sometimes 11 people that produce these 8 or 10 minute gems that, frankly, to this day, my sisters and I still quote. That's all. That's my rant. Anything to add to that?
I liked those cartoons as a kid, but animation today, it's come so far, it's so much better. It's not always, I mean, the writing isn't always better, the story, the...
You know what I notice about animation today, especially kids' animation? It's all screaming.
No, it depends on what you watch. Like, watch Legend of Korra. That's fantastic.
Okay.
Or Attack from Titan is amazing.
I'm waiting for you to say My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic. I know you're thinking it.
No.
So, okay, let's wrap up the cartoon thing. E, what was your favorite Saturday morning cartoon, either individual or series?
As a kid?
Yep.
Oh, geez. I'm not sure I even remember what was on when I was a kid. I have better memories of the weekday stuff, actually.
Yeah, so do I.
Because I think Saturday mornings as a kid, I think I wasn't watching cartoons. I think I was watching football.
Started early.
Yeah, but I remember watching...
Ah, because you grew up on the West Coast.
Yes.
That's right. That's right.
Okay. I remember watching, like, I would come home and I would watch all the crazy Sid and Marty Krofft stuff.
Ooh, H.R. Puffin stuff. That is a drug trip right there, right?
Yeah, and Electro Woman and Dinah Girl and Land from the Lost.
I don't know any of these things. I've never heard of any of these
things. Pop open Wikipedia.
Yeah, so I have much stronger memories of those.
Okay. What about you, Jeff?
Ren and Stimpy, like early seasons, I was probably like 11 or so, and those were amazing, and they hold up so well. The John K. Ren and Stimpys, they're incredibly subversive, and I kind of got some of it then, and they were just hideously gross. Man, I can still watch those.
All right, and then Laura, what about you with cartoons?
So I don't remember which days they came on, but I remember specifically watching a ton of He-Man and DuckTales.
Oh, DuckTales was classic.
So Saturday was the day you didn't have to go to school, Laura.
Thanks, Larry.
Okay. I know you like your school.
Thanks for clearing that up for me.
Hey, actually, I've got this question here, and it kind of dovetails with something I want to talk about right now. So I was at Syracuse University this week, up there dedicating. I'm a graduate of Syracuse. I was dedicating part of the dedication ceremony for the 50th anniversary of the Newhouse School of Public Communications, of which I'm a graduate. I was there with Oprah and a bunch of other folks, and you saw probably tweet some of these things going out. E, I don't even think I told you this story, did I?
I have not talked to you because I was on the East Coast, and then I think we crossed in the air.
Yeah.
You went east while I was coming back.
And what happened was is Saturday, I'm supposed to leave on Sunday. Saturday morning, I wake up, and my phone is lighting up. My flights have been canceled.
Ooh.
And I'm going, what is going on? This never happened to me before. Well, apparently there's a gentleman that had a few mental issues in Chicago and caused a severe disruption with the air traffic control in the Midwest.
Right.
So they canceled my flights because I was supposed to connect through Chicago onto Syracuse. So it all got rebooked. I went from Seattle to Denver, Denver to Atlanta, Atlanta to Syracuse. So I was all over the place on Sunday. So on the Denver to Atlanta route, because it was booked, you know, it was booked last minute, even because I was moved to this flight, I was sitting in a center seat. No. No bueno. So I'm sitting in the center seat, and there's this person is sitting next to me, and this person's rather large, I'll just say it. And so they sit down, and...
Syracuse just threw an interception. Sorry. Your team's literally playing right now against Louisville. So.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.
So this person is sitting next to me and so forth. So they get in their seat. And by the way, I'm in a window seat. Or they're in a window seat that has no window. I tweeted that photo out. Well, I'm about 2 hours in, and I'm kind of sitting in the middle. Laura, have you ever sat in the middle a lot? You've sat in the middle row, right?
Oh, of course I have, yes.
Yeah, everybody has.
Yes.
Now, wait. Yes. Hang on. Can we establish something?
Yes.
When you're in the middle, you get both armrests, right?
Well, that is my understanding. That is my interpretation of this gentleman's agreement.
But there's something to this, isn't there?
But because of the person sitting next to me, I was essentially tilted this way for 6 hours or 4 hours on the flight. So I'm nodding off because I'm tired. And then all of a sudden, I get woken up under the seat in front of this person. There's a bag. And I didn't know this, but the bag has two dogs in it. And they start fighting.
Oh,
and
no.
Speaking of cartoons, it's like the cartoons where the animals are going at it in the bag and you can see everything's going at it. I don't know what's going on. It's causing this racket, so I'm basically in an airborne dogfight. And they're going all over, and they're coming over into my side, and they're still in the bag, and they're trying to be fed. The flight attendant comes down and says, "Do you have the paperwork?" They say, "Well, I got through security." They had to go. It was a whole McGilla. And long story short was there was a dogfight in my row.
So I've never seen snakes on a plane, but I'm assuming it couldn't have been as entertaining.
Well, so I did not move for the entire flight. I could not move. Well, maybe like this. And it was one of the most uncomfortable, awkward flights that I have ever been on. And these dogs, I'm like, I told this person, I said, because I love animals. Everyone here on the show loves animals. I said, do you want to take the dogs out? They said, no, they can't come out. Really? Okay. So that's the story of the dogs on the plane. Any questions? Does the panel have any questions?
Oprah didn't have to deal with this, did she?
No, Oprah was with me at Syracuse and did not have to deal with that.
My flights were much better than your flights.
Yeah, I have, my wife as continually reminds me, I have the worst travel karma, period.
Apparently. I was on directs both ways, Seattle to D.C. They were both very smooth flights. I read a book on each flight. It was great.
This is not a good story, though.
No.
It was great for you.
Things in D.C. I can tell that story, but there was not a travel story. The travel itself was uneventful.
All right, moving along, we're going to go to the next question. This one's actually pretty straightforward, and Jeff and I were just talking about this earlier this week, weren't we, Jeff?
Yes, actually we did.
There were questions, because I need to get some more interviews for the podcast. This is in replace the podcast this week, in lieu of. And yes, absolutely, we've been quite busy with some other things, but we've got quite a few guests lined up for the coming show, so we're absolutely going to get through to that. So,
guess I better line those up then.
Now, this one is for a member of the show here. And can you all see it?
When you click on it, it takes like 10 or 15 seconds until it highlights for me.
And now we can see it.
Laura, would you like to field this one?
Yes. It says, Laura used to say that you were working on the Xbox Party feature. Can you say what other features you... I guess they're saying what other features you've worked on since or work on now? So I've worked on a few things since the party feature. I worked on Kinect, specifically the UI that you control, the Kinect guide, the Kinect dashboard, those types of things. But you know, and then a few other things after that in the dashboard. But the things that I work on now, unfortunately, are still confidential, and I can't talk about them. But maybe one day I will. Maybe one
so
day.
Just to level set for everybody watching us, when Laura says that, we don't even know what she's working on, and that is God's honest truth, right, guys?
Can't even get to where you sit.
Right. Yeah. We have no idea what she's working on. So all I know is that Laura, as you've heard me say in the show in the past, she's very smart, and I'm glad she's working on whatever she's working on, because I'm sure it's going to be awesome.
Thanks, Larry.
So there you go. So let's go to the next question. We'll just do a few more questions here while we're rolling through it here. So this next question is pretty straightforward. It is from Jack Penfold. Jack wants to know... it's a feature request. And Jeff, would you like to say what we do with feature? Why don't you read the question and then tell them what they should do?
So Jack Penfold says, might already be in the works, but is there an Xbox appear online, offline command coming, or at least be able to change it from the dashboard? This is an idea which I've seen pop up on Xbox Feedback. So you can vote feedback.xbox.com. Go ahead and, I would say, punch in those terms. Appear offline is, I think, how... it is probably on the site. Cast your vote in support of it. And I can promise you one thing, it's that we strongly look at these. There is actually an email thread that goes to, a huge amount of people in the company every week that shows what people are going for, what are the big movers, what are the top things, and this is something that folks are paying attention to the company. And I think we've seen a lot of things come to pass as of late, since we launched this in June. So we hear you loud and clear, and please use the system. It is really the best way to get through to the people who can do these things.
So yeah, that's absolutely right, Jeff. Feedback.xbox.com. There was a question earlier on about the November update, and I will say that some of the things in the November update are things on the feedback site. That's all I can say. I can't tell you which ones, but they are definitely there. So shall we continue with questions, ladies and gentlemen, or should we work on some other stuff? Do you want to talk about anything else? We're not going to do Xbox 101. E, I did it for you last week, by the way.
Oh, okay. What was it?
Jeff, do you remember?
No.
I was so confused. I think I had to step out when you guys were figuring out what
yeah,
I...
Yeah, you were...
We talked about it. Did we do it?
I did it.
I thought maybe the connection had dropped because it just went dead silent.
I knew as soon as I said that we did it for you, you were going to ask, and I apologize. I'm not prepared. The days seem to run together. I apologize.
Well, the days definitely run together. I'm with you on that one.
So we'll just continue taking some questions. If you guys can see the questions over there, feel free to take one and toss it and click on select.
I don't think we have that ability.
Yeah, I can't. I've been trying to figure out how that works, and I'm pretty sure you're the only one that can do that.
Huh. Okay, well, we'll find another one here. There's actually a question about gadgets. Do you guys want to talk a little bit about gadgets? I'm sorry, you go ahead.
Oh, I was going to take one, but so I'll take it real quick. Why not? Someone was asking, and I don't know what specifically they're referring to, but the question was, why are you doing that with an iPad and not a Surface Pro? And the simple answer is, it's really important to know what everyone is up to and not just you. Like, we work at Xbox. We play video games everywhere, on PC, on PlayStation, on Nintendo, and same thing with gadgets, whether it's a phone or something else. If you don't know what the competition's doing, you're not going to create a very good product. You have to use everything. Like, right now, for the last week, I switched over to an Android phone because I'd never used it.
And let me tell you something. There's nothing funnier than walking into E 5 minutes after he sets it up and he has no idea where anything is. I would have done the same thing. Yeah. I would have no idea where anything is.
It took me about half a day to figure out anything, and then it all came together once I figured out how widgets work and how to move them around. But then I had to learn things like, this is a Samsung phone and Samsung disables the ability to put widgets on the lock screen and yada, yada, yada. But you have to experiment. You have to learn. You got to use other people's products.
So we do all the time. So I'm sorry, E, so you said you can see the questions now? I'm a little confused.
I can see them, but when you click one to answer it, yeah, it doesn't show up as you are answering this question for at least 10 seconds.
Got it. Oh, I see.
So here's one, Larry, that if you don't mind, I'm going to take.
Go ahead and take it.
That is, when are you going to redo MajorNelson.com?
Ah!
And this is something that we're talking about right now. We're in the process of sort of evaluating what a next-gen MajorNelson.com would look like and
yep,
who would be suitable to build it. And, you know, very curious to know what you fans are interested in, what type of stuff we could surface or make easier to find. Or
yeah, Jeff and I have some really cool ideas. And if you guys have any ideas or sites of things that you like, send them major@xbox.com because we want to just blow it up and start all over and make it bigger, better, faster, extra crunchy, and shinier than ever before.
That's most of
the
adjectives.
It will whiten your clothes. No.
Could I cut a tin can with it?
Yes, why, yes you can, Jeff. Laura, do you have any questions in there you want to go through?
I want to know about the gadgets one. I don't see it. Which one was the gadgets one?
Oh, I don't know where it was. Guys, you got to vote these up and down accordingly. Mm-hmm. There's actually just someone saying they like the gadget section.
They don't sort, though, on my...
Oh, you're right, they don't.
There's a +3 and then a +10, then a +2, so I don't know what's going on.
All right, so I have one for E. Is E ready for the extra life this year? Backup generators prepared and Burger King Sneak King walkthrough printed out.
I love last year's Extra Life was challenging. I love Extra Life, but I actually have a schedule conflict this year and will not be able to do it. I may still do something at a later date because you don't actually have to do your Extra Life campaign on the day of Extra Life. That's just when most people do it. But I won't be doing anything on Extra Life Day proper this year. So,
boo. I'm sorry, that's my editorial.
I think we're getting trolled by Will Tuttle on here.
I've is it?
No, okay. Ignore him. Don't give him the satisfaction.
We already did. All right, let's see. Actually, E, I'm going to give you this next question. It's going to pop up in just a minute, so give it a second, and you'll see it pop up there in blue.
Da 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 da. Oh, where is Cthulhu?
Cthulhu
is here earlier. So if you were here at the beginning, Cthulhu made a brief appearance, and he doesn't like it when I video conference, just me talking with no other people in the room. So I can hear him. He's on the dog bed over there. But, oh, wait, here he comes. Cthulhu, come here. Come here, buddy.
We have another question up there that I'm going to let you guys take a look at before we fire it.
Come on. Kind of
dovetails on that.
Saturday morning. Oh, what childhood video game memories stick out? Oh, all of them.
Come here. Hang on.
All right.
Okay, let's see if I can get this dog in my lap.
He looks really uncomfortable.
It sure does.
Yeah. There we go.
Dog.
Sit. Do you want to sit on Daddy?
Awkward. Awkward.
Come here.
Oh, yep. All right.
Big puppy dog.
Can we get like a blur, like a pixelating, like a mosaic?
He's not normally a lap dog. He's a little big, but.
All right. So, Laura, question's up on the screen right now.
To coincide with Saturday morning cartoons, what childhood video game memories stick out?
All right.
For me, it would be all the games that I played, you know, growing up in school, because we had computer lab growing up with like an Apple II. So we played tons of Oregon Trail.
Oh, yes.
Loved that game. Many good memories with that one. And Word Munchers. Did you guys play Word Munchers?
Mm-hmm.
Anybody else play Word Munchers? I was really good at Word Munchers.
And were you best friends with Mavis Beacon?
Mavis Beacon?
Oh. Jeff?
It was the best typing tutor game before Typing of the Dead.
I didn't ever have to have a typing tutor because I think I just grew up normally knowing how to type. So I got to skip all my typing classes and stuff like that because I could just type already.
Did they call it typing when you were in school, Laura?
Keyboard.
Keyboarding, right? Keyboarding.
Yeah, for my son, it was keyboarding.
Yeah. Anyway, E, what about you? What video game memories do you have from school, from when you were younger?
Well, childhood. I guess it depends on when what you consider childhood. I got started on mini computers a little bit, and then. TRS-80 Model 1, anyone who had one of those remembers the Big Five games. I played a ton of Lode Runner on Apple II, Castle Wolfenstein, that kind of stuff. I had a 2600. And then I used to hack away at stupid little text adventures. I was in love with all the Infocom stuff,
and then I started
making my own. And I guess if you go a little farther, then all the Sid Meier games. So,
yeah, that's Jeff. Do you want to say what you have, and I'll bring up.
Yeah. So there's a million memories, but you jog my memory, Laura, about talking about playing in school. We had Apple IIs as well, and played Oregon Trail and stuff. But in our computer science class, there were some days where I think, and this is the Philadelphia school system at work, they were just like, just play games for the hour, and on those days. It was a GS in this. So at first it was 2E and then C, whatever order. Like they had like the green, but then in sixth or seventh grade we got the GSs, which were color.
Those were beautiful computers.
They were, and we had Tetris, and it took 8 to 10 minutes to load off the disk. Like no doubt, 8 to 10 minutes, but I knew if I timed it out perfectly, it was a 45-minute period. And if I loaded up immediately, I could get to level 10. I could go to the top level by the time class ended if I didn't lose. And we had actually a scoreboard on the side chalkboard that was a combination of students and teachers. And one time I got the most amount of lines that the school had ever seen at the time, which was like 107 or something like that. And it lasted, my record lasted for like a month, and that was like, you know, it was super proud. There was a group of about 4 teachers and about 6 students who were constantly jockeying back and forth for the best ever Tetris score.
Wow, that's impressive. I'm glad the teachers would jump in and try to get on the leaderboards too. That's great.
Yeah, why teach us when they can, No, it was fun. But and then later on, I actually got to meet Alexei Pajitnov, whoever invented it, and it was the worst game of Tetris I ever played. And he saw it, and I had a couple drinks in me, and I was sort of messing around, and I just screwed up, and I was like, eh. And I turned around, and he's there, like this, and it just goes.
Oh, and
I was like, no, I was good. It's great. I'm better than this. It was really upsetting. Did we lose Larry?
I think we did. He's not on the list anymore.
Because he met Alexei. I think they were in some. They did the Imagine Cup last year in Russia. No. Oh yeah, he just said he got dropped. He had been having cable modem problems all day, so he is indeed gone.
Whoops.
So inmates running the asylum. We're actually kind of. Oh wait, he's coming back.
We'll see. Did someone invite him?
Oh, there he is.
Okay.
We see you.
Hello, Larry.
I have a feeling it's not taken.
It seems his video hasn't loaded
I'm seeing disapproving Larry face.
sort of like a mugshot.
Yeah, half-lit profile shot with the turtleneck. Yeah, way to go, Larry. Very good.
Okay, well, let's just take a question while we're doing this.
Here's one for you, Laura, about nerd trivia. I don't know if you see it. Adam Kite asked any tech updates with Nerd Trivia development. I guess it said the iOS version is great. It was somewhere on your to-do list to bring it to other platforms.
Yeah. So one of my New Year's resolutions this year was to bring Nerd Trivia to another platform, to make a Windows Phone app, actually. And unfortunately, it's gone a bit slower than I've hoped. Work has been a bit more crazy, and Diablo 3 came out. So I've been playing that quite a bit in my free time. But I still plan on somehow, getting out sometime this year. So keep listening to the show or follow me on Twitter to hear further announcements for when that's going to hit the shop.
Cool.
All right, any other good questions?
It looks like there's a lot here. Oh, I think
Larry's trying to come back.
Hey, gang.
Oh, hey, Larry. Thanks for dropping in.
Yeah, sorry about that. That was fun. So I don't know. I'll tell you what happened in a minute and how I fixed it. But when you finish your stories,
I think we actually had just wrapped up. We took another question.
Yeah. So what was weird is I completely dropped out. So fortunately, and actually I don't know if I've talked about this. I know you know the story, E. But I actually have I'm kind of hardcore. I have two cable modems in my house, so I just switched over to the other one.
You have a redundant cable modem system.
Yes.
It's a good safety measure.
So, anyway, are we going through questions now, E? What did I miss?
Yeah.
Let me open questions over here. So, there they are.
We answered the nerd trivia question.
Oh, actually, no, I haven't talked about my childhood memory.
Oh, that's right.
So mine has to be, I used to go over to Rick Hyland's house after school. There were about four or five of us, and he's the only one that had Intellivision. And my thumbs hurt so much from pushing down on that disc when we were playing football. It was unbelievable. Do you guys remember that?
Oh yeah.
So that was probably my key memory, and the fact that all of a sudden we'd go over right after school, and then all of a sudden it's like 7 o'clock at night and dark out. Because when I was growing up, you had to be in the house by the time the streetlights came on. That was the rule.
You know what I discovered? Well, so two things. Number one, I discovered something really interesting about it in televisions not too long ago. So I bought an Intellivision from a friend, and I didn't know that there was a third-party accessory made back when the Intellivision was out that you put, like, attached it to the disc that basically turned it into a joystick. It's so much easier to play Intellivision games like
that. Oh yeah, I do remember that. It was this little. It looked like a toilet plunger.
No, hang on.
Well, the one I saw,
of course.
He's got one. He's just gonna go back into his cabinet and pull out all of his accessories.
Yeah. So for those of you that are just tuning in, E's house is a plethora of stuff, video game stuff. Like
perhaps even a museum. There's so much stuff.
These are the ones. So this is the one without it.
Right. Ow. Ow.
I don't have the other one handy, but I thought I did, but I don't. So.
I'm just imagining if we pan right, like I'll see your house on a future episode of Hoarders.
I am.
Well, that's right. You've not
celebrating our the hobby that gives us employment.
Actually, Jeff, you've never been to his house yet, have you? So we'll have to talk about that. Jeff, there's another question popping up in just a moment from Rob J, and I'd like you to answer this when you see it on your screen.
All right. Oh, what is the story behind my gamer tag? Did I not ever go through this? I mean, I'm happy to hear
it. I think you have. And...
Okay. Well,
we weren't listening. So.
Yeah, it sounds about right. You're not going to listen now either. So the first time I was ever in Japan or going to Japan for TGS back in the day, I became aware of a soccer team called Jeff United, J-E-F, which is Japan East Furukawa. So it's like the Japan Rail combined with the East Furukawa Power Company, and bam, I'm train power man Jeff United. And it's actually very close. It's the closest soccer team to where TGS is in Chiba. So it sort of all came together. And so my first time there, I went to this huge soccer store in Shibuya. And I go there and I'm like looking around and I'm finally finding some like Jeff United kits and scarves and things like that. And they're watching me, the proprietor's like watching me shop, and then they're frantically looking around for someone who speaks Japanese and English, and they finally find someone who spoke both languages, and this person comes up to me and he goes, "This team is very, very bad. Yeah. Do you really want to buy this?" And I had to like pull out my ID and explain that was like my name or reasonably close to my name. And at that point, like they started just throwing swag at me because they can't sell it. And
so
that's my gamer tag. It's
pretty funny.
And my favorite thing is they have every team in Japan has a slogan, and some are in English and some are in Japanese, but the Jeff United slogan is "Win by All."
All right. I can't disagree with that. Cool question here asking us if we're going to be at New York Comic Con. At this point, I don't believe so. Jeff, have you seen anything about that?
You know, I haven't seen anything about it. Just because we're not going to be there doesn't mean there wouldn't be – sometimes there's a booth or something like that, but I haven't heard anything to that effect.
I will say one of the things that Jeff – we can tell them what we're going to do in November, right, Jeff? Can I talk about that?
Oh, that one we can talk about for sure.
So I am very excited. I'm going back up to upstate New York to Syracuse. I'm going to be cutting the ribbon on the Microsoft store in Syracuse, and that will be in November. We'll have a blog post up on that when we're getting closer, and I will be inviting all of my – friends from Newhouse and Syracuse University, and I expect a lot of orange to come see me at the opening of that store.
And they mentioned...
Not the burnt orange like you get with Laura. This is more of a vibrant orange. Not that there's anything wrong with your orange.
You're just more of an orange.
Yeah, it's more of an orange.
I think the Gator orange is the same as the Syracuse orange.
It looks red up on your wall there.
Poor lighting. It's a medium orange.
It's a medium orange, so... E, would you like to have anything to talk about... Puddle Yellow and Moss Green?
No, I'm good on that.
Whisper Yellow.
I was actually going to talk about the Air and Space Museum, but given time, maybe I'll save that for...
Oh, are we? You're right. We're almost out of time. Wow, that was a heck of an hour. But yeah, you were. So when you were at Fraxicon, you also went to for the first time the Smithsonian, which Laura, have you been to the Smithsonian?
I have not. I really would like to go.
Jeff, have you been?
I've been to the Air and Space Museum, yes.
Okay. So anybody, regardless of where you are in the world and you can watch us, you must go to the Smithsonian. It is some of the most amazing amazing museum displays you will see anywhere on the planet. I mean, you see stuff here. The Air and Space Museum is just one of many, many of the Smithsonian's. It's essentially America's attic.
Yes. It was amazing. I took a whole bunch of pictures and tweeted, maybe a dozen. I did not get out, unfortunately, to Dulles and Udvar-Hazy, where they have a shuttle and a P-38 Lightning, which I really wanted to see, so I've got to plan another trip and get back.
So. Okay. All right, we are going to thank you for tuning in. We're going to wrap it up right now, guys. I need you to stay there for a second. We'll talk when we're done broadcasting. Thank you for tuning in. We may do this again, assuming my co-host would agree to that.
Sure.
Laura, by the way, Laura, thank you very much for the nice lighting. I know you've had some technical challenge. Well, we can see you. That's the most important thing. So thank you for participating. Jeff, thank you for your time.
Oh, anytime.
All right, E, we'll talk to you next time. And we'll
get thanked. Everyone else gets thanked.
I said thank you.
Thankless job.
All right, we'll talk to you guys next time. Just up on Twitter, I'm at Major Nelson. E is at
The Vowel.
Laura.
I'm at Laura Lollipop.
And, of course, Jeff is under
Jeff Rubenstein. So creative.
We'll see you guys next time. Thanks. Bye-bye.